Hey folks, today I want to talk to you about hair loss, balding, thinning hair, the inability to grow hair. I want to explain the real cause of this. Okay, a lot of people will blame genetics, they will blame the hormones, they will blame the foods they're eating, they will blame several different factors. And all these have valid points. But the actual underlying cause of your hair loss is acidosis. Now, what does acidosis mean? Acidosis means that your body has become highly acidic. You see, your body normally is alkaline or predominantly base. And when we consume foods that are acidic in nature, it turns the body to the acid side. And when this happens, we lose functioning of our kidneys, our lymphatic system, which is the main sewer system of the body, doesn't work properly, and we begin to have problems, okay? So the key element of why you are losing hair is that your body is acidic. And this acidity, well, it causes your lymphatic system, which is the system that removes all the acids from your 100 trillion cells through to the kidneys where it's eliminated. Now, when you consume acid foods like cooked starches, like animal products, it makes the lymphatic system hard or less fluid. And this in turn will prevent the acids leaving your 100 trillion cells from getting to the kidneys where they're eliminated, and which in turn will also affect the kidneys and their function. So these acids that normally are taken by the lymphatic system have nowhere to go, and they will back up and begin to burn tissue, organ, and glands. It will affect the hormones, and it will actually begin to burn hair follicles, okay? So this is how you truly lose hair. Now, people say, well, I have a genetic weakness and my parents were bald. It's not entirely true. What you do have is a lymphatic weakness, a genetic one, and your hair will your hair, the scalp region, because your family have to share the same kind of genetic structure, the weakness is in the head region, and therefore the acidity shows in the head region, which means the acid expresses itself in the head region. This does not mean that you cannot grow hair back again. It does not mean that you are doomed. It means that you can grow it back if you do the right things, and this is why I'm here today, to show you how to do the right things. So the first step you have to do is stop consuming those foods that are causing the acidosis, and these are the animal products and the cooked starches and anything cooked. You want to switch to 100% fruits, okay? You can go to oranges, watermelon, grapes, any fruit is going to do it. The reason why we use fruits is because fruits are hydrating, they are alkaline. Think of them, when you consume them, as being like little firemen that put out the fires, inflammation in your body. The inflammation being a response to the acidosis or the acid in your body. So fruits will quench all these fires out, will turn the body alkaline, will hydrate the cells, will they are astringent, so they will pull toxins out and mucus, and they'll get your cells hydrated and functioning properly, okay? So you wanna go on fruits, breakfast, lunch, and dinner for as long as you can go. Your diet should be predominantly raw fruits and veggies, but if you really wanna heal fast, you go on 100% fruits for as long as you can. So that's step one. Step two is you want to use herbs for the scalp, okay? We need to take herbs to help our body function properly. Herbs are tissue specific. That means you can find a herb that's specifically for the kidneys, for the adrenals, for the lymphatic system, for the stomach and bowels, and for the endocrine system, which is the glands on that control all aspects of the body, okay? Like the pituitary gland, the thyroid, parathyroid, the adrenals, all these are controlled and can be improved by using herbs, okay? Herbs are crucial because they give you that added boost. So when we're trying to heal and trying to get the body better, we want to make sure that all the systems of the body are working properly. And these, as I mentioned, are the adrenals, kidneys, lymphatic system, endocrine system, and stomach and bowels. When these major parts are fixed, the body can function properly and you eliminate all those acids and waste, and your hair and skin will begin to grow back again, okay? I mean, your skin will glow, your hair will grow. Now, this is very simple. These plants, they accentuate, or they help the cells clean themselves out. They strengthen. Very, very important. There are quite a few of them, too long to list here, but you can get a tincture that has all the herbs you need in one bottle, okay? We call it the Fab Five, and you take this, and you go on the 100% fruit protocol, and you'll be doing all you can to detox the body and get it clean and healthy so they can function properly. Now, this is not it's entirely about hair loss. It's actually about health, because the health of your body is indicated by the health of your hair and vice versa. If your hair is falling out, it means there's something wrong inside the body, okay? And so they work in line together. When you get healthier, your hair is going to grow. There's no two ways about it. It's that simple. So that's taken care of. We go on 100% fruits. We go on the herbs. And there are also herbs specifically for blood circulation to the scalp. Okay, herbs like butcher's broom. They work fantastic to boost blood to the scalp. Gotu Kola is another one. Ginkgo leaf is a third one. There's quite a few, that too much to listen. Cayenne pepper extract is another one. It just boosts blood flow to the scalp. And when you put the blood in this head region, you can function better, you think better, the mucus moves from the head better, and the hair begins to grow better as well. So you have all these things combined together. The third thing you can do is apply hair oils to the scalp with herbs. Now, there are certain herbs used in Asia and India that are well known to help hair grow. These are like herbs like amla, which has 30 more times vitamin C than an orange. Ichthyosiri radix, which is a plant from Japan that takes about 7 to 8 years to mature. And this plant is known as a vasodilator. This means it thickens, it widens the blood vessels going to the scalp. This is more blood flow, more hair growth. There are plants like hibiscus, which was shown in a study to boost hair growth by 30%. You know, exceptional plants, and there are actually quite a few of them. And it's very hard to get them, and very hard to come by. So, you know, we took the time and effort and we put them all in one bottle called Grow Hair Oil. Now, you don't have to use this, you can find your own. But if you want all the herbs put together in the right concentration, in the right order, and the right plant species, well, it's all done for you here. So, all these I mentioned here, it's not magical. These are tools that are going to help you feel better, get healthier, and in return, your hair will grow in a response. Okay, for the hair to grow, you have to get healthy. You have to detoxify yourself. Detoxification means cleaning up the body and allowing the body to function as it was meant to function. It means removing the obstruction and the mucus that are causing health issues and slowing hair growth and causing hair loss. When you put all those parts together, you're going to have amazing health. You're going to feel great. Your skin is going to glow. Your hair is going to grow. There's nobody who goes on this program and sticks to it for 4 to 6 months. Okay, you need some time, because hair takes time to grow and the health of the body takes time to recover. In other words, it can take a little time for you to get healthier, and in return your hair will grow and the skin will glow and you're going to feel amazing. You might even drop a few pounds, okay? So it's that simple, folks. It's just a matter of following a simple protocol. Go on 100% fruits to clean up the body. Use herbs internally and herbs externally. Be patient and watch what happens. You'll feel the difference in a few weeks. There's no way you're not going to feel healthier going on an all fruit / veggie program. There's no one out there who can deny this. And you go onto this program and you add the herbs, you're going to feel a transformation. And I can tell you for a fact that you understand the true power, healing power of herbs, plants, and fruits. It's exceptional. You deserve this. Everyone does deserve good health. So give it a try. Try and see for yourself. But if you really want hair growth, especially if you're balding, you need to give it 6 months. 6 months is a good number, and you're gonna see massive improvements. I cannot say this enough, okay? So if you truly wanna go for this, click the link below. I have everything you need down there. Again, I'm not making any exceptional promises. I'm telling you this is a way to heal. Heal the body, heal the scalp, heal the skin. It's healing, it's not a treatment. We're not taking a miracle product and your hair is going to bloom up, okay? I personally went through this myself. I was thin on the top. In fact, I didn't even know, and my hairstylist told me about it. And I took these steps. I went from eating meat products and cooked starches, full-blown meat eater, and I went to this lifestyle, and it completely transformed me. So I'm here to share this with you. I want you to get the benefits as well. I'm not trying to force you to do anything. This is works, but it takes time, and it works exceptionally well, and it's an overall health factor. You're going to get healthier, you're going to feel better, and you're going to think better. Your science is going to clear up. It's that powerful, that amazing. So I hope you do give it a try. Click the link below, you know, get more information and begin.